Hey guys, good morning and a happy new year. I hope this year treats you better. Unlike 2020, it was a disaster for all of us, we know. And now that things are eventually better and we are out on our motorcycle touring, taking our car out, I think it's a much better situation at this stage. Now, this video is all about the ADV Conquest windshield that I purchased for my motorcycle. I did weigh out all the options that I had, the cost, and I really narrowed down to the ADV Conquest windshield. I have finally got the product. Let me show you. So guys, this is the whole package that you get for your windshield. I got the smoked one. You can also opt for a transparent one. If I tell you, this windshield, I didn't think it will be this thick, but trust me on this, it's quite good quality. And what I really love is the clarity. There is no optical distortion. There are some rubber mounts over here. I'm struggling to get focus on this. I'm sorry about that. Yeah, so there are some rubber washers over here, and you can see the thickness. I'm not sure if you can. Yeah. And other than that, they have a metal clamp which looks like a drone skeleton or somewhat like that. It's quite heavy, and some really good quality bolts and nuts. These are all thread locked, so you shouldn't have any issues with them loosening or coming out. I like to keep things this way. What we are going to do is we will be installing the windshield on the motorcycle, and we will double check if the process told by ADV Conquest, I mean they told that it's relatively simple, so we will try to do it and we will try to figure out if it is as simple as they claim it to be. How it is on the motorcycle, that review will come on later on. But for now, we will just proceed with the installation. Now, today I am single-handed, so you might not get a continuous footage for every step that I do, but I'll try to collate and put in every information that I could possibly think of. Stay tuned. To begin with, I would first open the stock windshield. Since I have my toolkit, I'm using it to open it. But if you don't, you can use the Allen key provided in the stock toolkit. Please don't ask me questions like which size and whatnot, because that's something you'll really have to figure out. Once the windshield is out, you have to install the base plate, and using these Allen keys provided, Allen screws provided, I would place it on the motorcycle and then I would continue the video. Without the windshield, your mount, base mount, should look like this, and you should install this in a manner that the wider arms are on the lower section. Secure the mount with the Allen screws provided, and use both the mounting positions and tighten it. Don't tighten it too hard so that it breaks the original grooves on the stay. But yeah, just do it as much as it would be required based on your understanding. It should look somewhat like this. Position the windshield in this manner and fix the same using the screws and bolts provided. Now, once it is done, you need to tighten these screws. Now remember, whenever you're installing a windshield or a windshield extender or anything of that sort, you don't tighten each bolt in one go. You tighten them eventually and you always go crisscross. There. This is how it looks after installing the windshield. Now trust me on this, the windshield is very tall, and the visibility is quite good. Now, what I have been promised by ADV Conquest is that I'm 5'10, so this should deflect the wind right above my helmet. Now I will check that out on my next ride and I will let you know on the same. Now that the windshield is installed, I would proceed towards installation of the headlight protector. This is what you get in the headlight protector kit. The screw, all the Allen key screws and the protector and the clamps. Start by cleaning the headlight properly. I have used a windshield cleaner that I use in my car. It's hydrophobic in nature. And right after, I have also applied some ceramic coating so that it stays clean for a longer time. And then I have to pop this open. Now this is a very simple thing. It's just hooked right below over here. So all you need to do is put in a screwdriver and pop it open outwards. It would just come out. It's nothing that difficult to take. So I'm using this very basic screwdriver, and what I'll be doing is I'll push it from below, ensuring that I don't touch the body panels, and I will push it outwards. You see, it just popped and fell. So it's just a very basic thing. This was inside. This is the position where you would be putting in this mount. Now before you start with the process, you would have to open up these two screws that hold the number plate, and you'll have to loosen this bolt. Now this is not mandatory, but then this is something which is recommended so that when you install the entire thing together, you have some free play on this plastic panel to play with. So I have my ratchet. I'm using the same to open the bolt, or rather loosen it. Again, please don't ask lame questions like which size and whatnot, because if you're doing a DIY and if you have a kit, that is the basic you should be able to figure out. You really don't need to ask which number of screwdriver and which Allen key you need. Okay. These two you need to open completely. Sorry guys, I got interrupted by a call. And let's proceed with the opening. Now this is loose enough. I can probably open it using my hands. Once it is done, loosen these bolts, this one and the one at the other extreme. Now I have tried opening it and putting in the clamp and then tried to install it back. Keshav from ADB Tribe, he mentioned that he did not face any issues on his bike or any of the customers' bikes that he has installed it, but I was struggling to get this in place. I was unable to slot it. So what I have done is I have loosened it up enough so that there's enough slack, and I'm going to slide this through the center. Yeah. And the plan is that I'm going to position the shorter screws that I have. So these are the longer ones, these are the shorter ones. I will try to position these through the lower holes and then tighten up the entire thing. So I have managed to get the bolts in. You can see that I have used one steel washer and one plastic washer, and then I'm planning to tighten them eventually. So first I would be probably tightening the ends and then the center. Once the lower clamp is installed, you need to install the headlights protector right over here and use the small Allen key against this hole and this one. So I'll proceed with the installation and then I'll show you how it goes. Although I'm sure it won't have any fingerprints or anything of that sort, still I would recommend that you clean it once using some kind of soap or a windshield cleaner and then proceed with the installation. So I've cleaned the headlight protector, especially the inside, and I have applied a layer of ceramic coating. I'll just wait.
sorry. I'll just wait for a couple of minutes for this to bond, and then I would install it on the headlight. Say hi. So I have positioned the headlight protector, and I have used a small Allen key that was provided in the kit over there. Now I would be installing the lower part. If you notice that I have not tightened it completely, so that's something you need to keep in mind. Once you have fixated the headlight protector on top, you need to use the third piece at the bottom in this direction and screw in using the last small Allen key screw that was provided. Now remember, when you're installing this, you are not supposed to tighten the entire thing in one shot, as I told you before. So you need to attach this part, keep it loose. You need to attach this part, get everything aligned, and then eventually tighten both of them. Now I did have a word with Keshav from ADV Conquest, and I asked him about the long Allen screws that he provided, and it's something which is very well thought of. What he told me is that some people use auxiliary lights on their motorcycle, and I dropped one of the Allen keys, and many of the stays are using this mount. Let me show you from the other side. It's a little dark on this side, this one. So in that case, you would need those longer Allen screws to keep everything in place. But since my mount that I am using, I do not use that same mounting position, doesn't make any difference. Let me show you. This is the mounting position that I use. This is how the entire thing looks now with the headlight protector and the windscreen. This is a quite snug fit, I must say. It's not moving much, and all in all, it looks pretty good. One thing though, the low beam pattern has definitely changed a little. There used to be a sharp cutoff before, and there's a slight glare here and there that I can notice. High beam is still okay. This is the low beam where I see a difference. I think you will be able to see the cutoff line now better. This is what I also see in person. I'm not sure if this is going to help or if this is going to be a problem, but again, let's hope it's not a problem. The top of 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 the top of